All right, I'm going to use the quantum theory to explain why, how come does hydrogen emit only 4 light spectrums. Okay, so from use the quantum theory, so energy is quantized, so it's not continuous. We're going to use that to explain light spectrums of hydrogen. Why does hydrogen have this pattern? All right, and I'm going to use Niels Bohr. Get help from Mr. Niels Bohr to explain that. Anyone remember what is his atomic model called? The planetary model. Okay, so look like a solar system, nucleus in the middle, proton, neutron, and the electron is orbiting around it, around the nucleus. All right, and there are energy levels. We have level 1, 2, 3, 4. If the electron is at energy level 1, so n equal to 1, so the closest to the nucleus, we call this a ground state, the lowest energy. And anything else, any other energy level beyond the ground state, we call it excited state. That's it. Okay. All right. Let's say if we heat up, add an energy to this atom, to this electron specifically. All right. This electron at the ground state will get excited. That's what the word they use, get excited to the excited state. Okay. And then once it has high energy at the excited state, it's not stable. It will come down, go back, relax back to the ground state and release that energy that it received earlier. All right. If we heat even more energy, the electron will jump up to a higher energy level, stay there for a while, not that stable, and then relax back to the ground state and release more energy. Adding even more energy, go up to a higher energy level, relax, and then relax back, release even more energy. Adding the infinite amount of energy, what's going to happen to the electron? It'll just fly away. So, all right. How do we use the quantum theory? They're saying that the energy is quantized. It's got to be only a specific number. It can be any number. The energy that absorb the electron can absorb from and make electron jump from level 1, the ground state, to level 2. It's got to be exactly the same with the energy different between energy level 1 and 2. It got to be this specific number. Let's say 10 kilojoule per mole. Alright. Now, the higher energy that make electrons go jump from energy level 1 to level 3 is going to be exactly the same with the energy different from level 3 to level 1. Let's say 15 kilojoule per mole. This electron need to have 15 kilojoule per mole to jump up to the level 3. If you add 14, it won't go. 13, it won't go. 10, it won't. Or 10, it just go to level 2. Right, 9 doesn't do anything. 8 doesn't do anything. Right, if you add 10, go to level 2. If you add a 15 kilojoule, go to level 3. And same thing with level 4. And let's say 20, you have to add 20 kilojoule per mole. So if you jump up to level 4, 19, 18, 18 and a half doesn't go. Okay, so that's why the energy is quantized. All right, now I'm going to explain the light spectrum of the hydrogen atom. Okay, if the electron transitioning down, relax down from level 3 to 2, the energy that coming out right here, that release right here, is falls into the red color in the visible light region. Okay, that's why you see the red right here. So 3 to 2. Another one. So if this electron start from level 4, relax down to level 2, the color is cyan, okay? Falls into the visible light region and you can actually see it, all right? And from level 5 to 2, that's a blue. And we have level 6 to 2, that is the violet, all right? So that's the reason why you never see in the rainbow, light from the hydrogen atom as a rainbow, as a band. You see as a line, because of there's a energy, specific energy level and a specific energy that is released. So it can be any number. So this shows that the energy is quantized. So it can be any number. Okay. All right. Now, concept test real quick. So if you get what I mentioned before. So when an atom releases light energy, what happens to its electron? What happened? Well, the electron look at the process here. If you heat up the electron jump up to the high energy level, right, higher. And when the atom releases energy, the electron relax back down to the lower energy level. Okay. Alright, is light absorbed or emitted in the following process? A, an electron moves from level 2 to 4. 2 to 4 is just like go up the stair. You need, it takes energy to going up the higher energy level. So add energy, right? So this one absorb energy. And B, an electron moves from level 6 to level 3. Coming down the stair, easy. So release the energy. Alright. C, an electron is excited to a higher energy level. Get excited. Just go up higher energy level. Go, good. So same thing. Add energy into it. So absorb energy. And oh, that's it. Yeah. All right. We have class activity number 2, question 1 and question 2. I give you a hint for question 2. Okay. All right. Quite fun thing to talk about still. All right. Let's go to the next video. We got some more stuff to talk about.